Okay, this here is my ball and beam balancer, and it's all analog beam angle control. It's got three separate power supplies, DC motor, the beam. The 0 to 10 volt 10 LED dot bar display drivers LM3914 to display the proportional, integral, derivative, sum, beam angle after the amp, and wall angle after the amp. This is the actual controller here itself. There's two 10 volt precision power supplies on there, and there's one adjustable voltage power supply. The adjustable one goes to the motor, which also has a PWM, which is kind of overkill in hindsight, but it's all right. We got one, this is a schematic. Let's see if I can get it to focus here. Not really. But basically, this is the power supply section. So we have the beam angle. It comes through down through a 3-ohm power resistor, which is this big resistor in the back there. And then we run that through the actual beam, and then we send a signal back via the ball. So this is the ball amplifier. Then we've got a error amplifier. This is where the set point position comes in. We've got the microcontroller coming in there right now, just providing a voltage for set point. This is your kind of your standard PID set up, and these are the values that I ended up using. This is your PID out and inverter. Two stages of gain there as well, but it's kind of redundant. Probably could just have one gain. This is where the beam potentiometer comes in, and this gets set up for like a 0 to 10 volt range from upper to lower, or maybe you add 1 and 9 on the top, and then this will be your upper and lower limits so it can stop the beam before it crashes in any one direction, so it can only go so far. So this is where it decides what direction it's going to run into the 298, L298. Got the gear motor down there. This is a PWM generator for the enable pins on the 298, which with the adjustable voltage is not completely necessary, but it's just nice to have the adjustability there too. And then you got your virtual ground, which is just set at 5 volts for all the amplifiers, because this is running from a single-sided supply. So I just create like a virtual ground, I call it, set it in the middle, and then use 0 to 10 volts for everything. So this is where what all the things do. There might be mistakes in this. It's all just like, as we go, I try to document the ones that are a bit harder to keep track of. So, especially with the values. So anyways, that's that. And then it's got the little microcontrollers right here that just is going through an R2R network with an 8-bit output. Actually, no, I think it's a 10-bit output, so I can just use this remote control to change the set point, move it around. You can really watch the air lamps if you give it a good smack. You can see that a lot of derivative in this is it tries to catch the ball from overshooting. A good one there. There it goes. Anyways. A little bit of dust on there, I think. it sits just on one side of the set point either way, your integral will start to ramp up slowly, but there's not a whole lot of integral in this thing. It's mostly proportional and derivative. But that's basically it, and the schematic. So theoretically, you could build one and tune it until you die from it. Because it does take some time to get it tuned, I'll tell you that much. But it was a fun project.